part for magnetism and electromagnetism. Remember, please subscribe, like, and share good comments because single word of education continues rewards in this world and after for those who know. So, please share it. Galvanometer. It is a device used to measure the magnitude and direction of currents. Types of galvanometer. 1. Moving magnetic galvanometer. 2. Moving coil galvanometer. Moving coil galvanometer. In moving coil galvanometer, coil of the wire is freely rotate because of couple principle. When a moving coil is placed in a magnetic field and current is passed through it, to equal and opposite force, couple cause the coil to rotate against the opposing force. Construction. 1. A rectangular coil. 2. Horseshoe magnet. 3. Hairspring. 4. Iron core. 5. Pointer. 1. Rectangular coil. A rectangular coil of copper wire is wound on a light frame of non-magnetic material. Vertical sides of the coil are perpendicular to the magnetic field. 2. Horseshoe magnet. There is a large horseshoe magnet with concave-shaped poles. The coil frame is provided between the jaws of this magnet. 3. Hair springs. Hair springs are attached at both ends of the coil. These springs help in keeping the coil at zero potential and provide the path for the entry and exit to the current for iron core. A soft iron cylinder is fixed in the core of the coil to enhance the force on the conductor. 5. Pointer. A pointer is attached on the top of the coil. At deflection shows the direction and amount of current. Working. When current passes through the side coil, perpendicular to the field lines, the sides wires of the coil experience forces in opposite direction. Couple. On one side the current passes upwards. On the other side it passes down. Measurement and direction of the current. Direction of rotation of the coil depends on the direction of current through the coil. When current passes, pointer rotates to either side showing the direction of the current and it will measure the amount of current. Also, when the pointer moves to the end of the scale, we call it a full scale deflection, FSD. Ammeter. It is a modified form of galvanometer which is used to measure a large amount of current. To convert a galvanometer into ammeter, a low resistance wire shunt is connected in parallel to galvanometer coil. Construction. 1. A rectangular coil. 2. Horseshoe magnet. 3. Hairspring. 4. Iron. 5. Pointer. 6. Shunt. 1. A rectangular coil. A rectangular coil of copper wire is wound on a light frame of non-magnetic material. Vertical sides of the coil are perpendicular to the magnetic field. 2. Horseshoe magnet. There is a large horseshoe magnet with concave-shaped poles. The coil frame is pivoted between the jaws of this magnet. 3. Hair spring. Hair spring are attached at both ends of the coil. These spring help in keeping the coil at zero potential and also provided the path for the entry and exit to the current for iron. A soft iron cylinder is fixed in the core of the coil to enhance the force on the conductor. 5. Pointer. A pointer is attached on the top of the coil. Its deflection shows the direction and amount of current. 6. Shunt. It is a low value resistance connected in parallel with the coil of galvanometer. Connection in circuit. An ammeter is always placed in series with other circuit components through which the current is to be measured. working when current is allowed to pass through the ammeter. Shut resistance, which is placed in parallel to the coil of the galvanometer, bypasses the great part of the current. Only a small known fraction of the total current passes through the coil of galvanometer. On passing current, coil becomes magnet. Attraction or repulsion between the poles of permanent magnet and coil magnet causes of a deflection in the coil, which is indicated by the movements of pointer on the scale. Remember, please subscribe, like, and share good comments, because single word of education continues rewards in this world and after for those who know. So, please share it.